It's Wednesday and I'm following in the wake of yesterday's video, but with tinsel in my hair as it's the Wednesday before Christmas kind of thing. Like, I thought I'd talk about refugees. So, like, oop. Really need to secure this before I do anything else. According to the UN Refugee Convention, a refugee is someone who is owing a well-founded has fears of being persecuted for like reasons such as race, religion, nationality, membership of a particular social group or political opinion, is outside the country of his or her nationality and is unable to or own to such fear, is unwilling to avail himself to the protection of the back country. It's like, which now in the article that I'm reading, like from refugeeaction.org.uk, like goes on to explain what a asylum seeker is, and the asylum, from what I can understand, the asylum seeker is someone who goes to a country and was undecided whether they are actually a refugee or not, or just someone who happens to be in that country. They are known as asylum seekers. And they might. As an asylum seeker, you don't have the same rights as like a refugee or someone who is a citizen of that country. They gave the example of you're not allowed to work. And there's 117,234 refugees in this country, and these figures are as of mid-2015. So it's not sure what they are end of 2017. And then there's 37,829 pending asylum for the UK, and about 16 people that are currently stateless. And it's after Syria and all that. We're all here, these stories, refugees crossing from Syria into Europe and all that. I remember a little over a year ago when the Rio de Janeiro Olympics were going on, one of the people under the Independent Olympic Committee, there was one team for refugees, and I think she was on that one. She essentially swam a boat to safety. How to do that, I don't know, but I love people like that, that have humanity. Another place you could say that they're refugees and all is Iraq, as it's Syria and Iraq. Probably two biggest contributors to Europe and the UK. As of the civil war and all, Syrian civil war and the rise of ISIS, the rise of Islamic State. I don't particularly like Islamic State. Like, I don't believe what they stand for. I guess, like, I prefer everyone having their rights, and but, like, I've heard slave prides and, like, things like slave prides and all that kind of thing. So, like, how can you do that? So, like, some of things are inconceivable to, like, law students. But, like, and we're forced to face them. Yes, but like, on your hand, on asylum, it's like, I know South Korea grants asylum to people that are defected from North Korea, like, them granted immediate asylum and, like, refugees and all, of, like, refugee status and all that. Yes, but like, as I don't particularly believe in North Korea either, so like, I don't believe in excusing people just for owning a CD that happens to be illegal. So like, and I don't like being controlled like that, like being going from like the outside, you tend to hear all the dark secrets of countries like North Korea and like all these other countries, but rarely your own. Which is nice, but like, I know, as I know, that no country is flawless. It's just everything these days with like tensions rising. Between North Korea and America. So thanks a lot, Donald Trump. You're really a competent president. So yeah. And it's like the one thing, and it's like, I remember like earlier this year. Like, I remember watching, like, news or something like that, and apparently Kim Jong-un called Donald Trump a dotard. But, like, I remember watching it somewhere with a third party, and he kind of said the definition. But, like, dotard is, like, an old person, especially one that is weak or senile. And then it's, like, kind of made you laugh, giggle a little bit. So, yeah. Refugees and all that. It's like, doesn't seem like the most pleasant experience out there. And it's more like, I hope Syria and Iraq could soon. Although I doubt that it will be sorted out very soon, as neither Assad or anyone Islamic State or anyone seem to be backing down anytime soon. So yeah. So yeah, it's really, I hope everything gets resolved, so especially around Christmas. It's like, fingers crossed it will be all sorted out at some point. And they are able to go home eventually. that's probably it for this video. Tomorrow I'll probably be talking about war and all that. It's been like kind of leading on from this video and yesterday's video. So yeah, see you tomorrow.